Hey there guys, we're taking a look at Need for Speed Payback running on the AMD Ryzen 5 5500U. Now we took a look at Need for Speed Heat last time and the performance that we were getting on there was pretty rough, but at 1080p Payback seems to be running relatively smooth here. We're getting averages that are in the 30s, but with 1% lows of 25, the experience overall is actually not too bad. Everything seems to be overall really smooth and consistent here. And while a 30fps average is certainly not ideal, it's definitely at least doable here. And really, if you're somebody that grew up playing on consoles, you might actually be very accustomed to this kind of FPS. And while this is the lowest in-game graphics settings, it is the full 1080p resolution. And since it is the full 1080p resolution here, everything does look relatively clear. And really, overall, it's a very impressive level of performance that we're getting out of this game here, especially considering we're just at the 15-watt TDP. Now, we can't try to improve this by just dropping the resolution down to 720p, so let's see what that looks like right now. Now at 720p, the averages that we're seeing here are very solid with a 50fps average, though the 1% lows did not see as big of an uplift as before, seeing only about a 5fps uplift. But overall, that does keep the 1% lows at above 30fps, which is what I normally try to target here. So the fact that we're pretty much at that line means that the level of performance that we're getting here is very decent. And considering this is all at the stock TDP, I'm pretty impressed and I'm very happy to see these levels of results out of this. That being said, we can try to squeeze more out of this by just raising the TDP so we can take a look at what 25 watts does to this game. Now at the 25 watt TDP, we do see somewhat of an uplift in the 1% lows, though it's nothing significant and the averages overall are just staying above 30, but not by a significant margin. So it is a small improvement in the overall performance, but it's nothing major. Really, it's those 1% lows that are making the biggest difference here. It's enough of an uplift to make a slight difference, but it's nothing groundbreaking here. And we're still not hitting the 30 mark that I would like to see for the 1% lows, but overall, just keeping such a tight 1% low to average ratio has pretty much made this experience extremely smooth, and this is going to be a very enjoyable experience overall. That being said, dropping down to 720p is really going to net you the best results here because we are now at a 60fps average with 1% lows that are only slightly under 45. And really overall, the result that you're going to get like this is going to be significantly better than running at 1080p. So just like Need for Speed Heat, this really seems to be a 720p game, 900p if you're really sensitive to resolution, but 1080p just really feels like you're kind of pushing it in comparison to the level of performance you can get by just dropping the resolution. Overall, though, I am happy to see that the results that we're getting at both 1080p and 720p are impressive, though 720p really just seems to be the way to go. Now, if we use the performance preset to set the TDP to 30 watts, the level of performance that we get at 1080p is, again, not too bad, though nothing incredible. The 1% lows don't really see any uplift whatsoever. It's mostly our averages that see an improvement. So overall, the gain that we see is really minimal, because what you really want to see is an uplift in those 1% lows more than anything else. And at this point, we are pumping a lot of wattage through this chip and it's generating quite a bit of heat. So overall, not a great experience, especially because we're not seeing any meaningful gain here. So overall, very disappointed to see how the performance preset is doing here. You're really pushing a lot more wattage to see practically no gain in this game. I mean, the temperatures that we're at already are at a level where I just don't feel comfortable trying to play like this. 720p is a similar story, though here at least we do see somewhat of an uplift in the 1% lows. It's nothing major, and overall going down to the 25 watt TDP is just going to be better because this is really so much heat that we're almost at 90 degree temperatures on the chip. I don't personally like seeing these levels, and already the game was pretty playable at the stock TDP, so you're pumping out a lot here just to try to see somewhat of an improvement, and I really don't think it's worth it. And lastly, we could take a look at it running on the battery saver preset, which is just an 8 watt TDP. It is a slideshow, so really not doable like this at all. This 8 watt TDP is really just something that's not really meant for these older APUs. Really, it seems like Ryzen 3 based ones are the only ones that can really truly utilize it. But overall, I want to thank you for watching. I really appreciate it, and I will see you in the next one.